Struggling to understand how your Meta ads are performing in Google Analytics 4 and feeling a bit overwhelmed by all those reports and data that you're seeing in GA4? Well, there's an easier way. Today, I'm going to show you how to track your Meta ads using Google Analytics so you can see what happens after people click on your ads, where they go, how long they stay, and if they're converting. And the best part is you can see what's going on with your Facebook ads without ever leaving your WordPress site. Meta Ads Manager has some cool insights, but sometimes the data just doesn't match up with what Google Analytics says, and that's going to make it hard to tell if your Meta Ads are really paying off. So what's the solution? If you're a WordPress user, the easiest way to install your Meta Pixel is with the Monster Insights PPC Ads Tracking add-on. Monster Insights is the best Google Analytics plugin for WordPress. It allows you to easily connect your WordPress site with Google Analytics so you can view all the data that matters most right on your WordPress dashboard. Plus, with just a click of a button, you can set up sophisticated tracking features such as event tracking, PPC ads tracking, e-commerce tracking, form tracking, custom dimension tracking, outbound link tracking, and a whole lot more. Now to get started, you'll need to grab Monster Insights at the Pro level license and then activate the PPC ads tracking add-on. Setup is easy, but if you need help installing and connecting your WordPress site to Google Analytics using Monster Insights, then check out our post on how to add Google Analytics to WordPress the right way. I'll leave a link in the description. All right, after you're all set up, you'll need to install the PPC ads tracking add-on. Now to do that, just head to Insights and then to Add-ons. And then find the PPC ads add-on. Now just click install. Now once you're done, you'll just need to enable Meta Ads Tracking. You can do that by going to Settings, and then to Conversions, and then paste in your Pixel ID. All right, the next step is to create UTM parameters. It's super easy. If you don't use URL parameters on your links, then your traffic is all going to be lumped together in a paid social channel. But when you use UTMs, well, you'll be able to organize your ads into groups and then easily see what's working and what isn't. All you have to do is head over to Insights and then to Tools. Now you'll see the URL builder. Now to build your UTM, just enter the URL that you want to track along with its parameters. You'll only need to fill out the website URL, but it's super helpful if you fill out the other fields as well, like your campaign source, that's the traffic source for the link placement, in this case it's Facebook, the campaign medium, which is going to help you know if your Facebook ad traffic is coming from your regular Facebook traffic, and the campaign name field is where you can give your Facebook ads campaign a name to help you track the performance of individual ad campaigns. Now just copy and paste your UTM link into the destination field in your Facebook Ads Manager. And since we're using the Monster Insights URL Builder, you can leave the URL parameters field blank in your Meta Ads Manager. Now to check your Facebook ads in Monster Insights, all you have to do is go to Insights and then to Reports and then to Traffic and then click on the Campaigns tab. Now in the campaign column, you're going to see the number of visitors each of your ads is directed to your site, plus other key performance metrics like the revenue that's been generated by each of your campaigns. Now by using the Monster Insights Plus license or higher, you also get the benefit from its dedicated social media report. To see that report, just head over to Insights and then to Reports and then to Traffic and then to Social Media. Now you'll see things like the sessions, the engaged sessions, the bounce rate, the purchases, revenue, and conversion rates from your social media channels. This is going to give you a complete overview of your social media performance. Now, if you found this breakdown of how to track Facebook ads in Google Analytics helpful, go ahead and smash that like button and hit subscribe for more tips on understanding your website's performance. Up next, you'll definitely want to check out this video where I show you the easiest way to connect Google Analytics to Facebook.